Kirsty Meakin. Welcome to the Nao Nails channel. I'm going to be doing a butterfly for you today, on a nail, obviously. We're going to use gel polish. It's going to be beautiful. It's going to look that realistic. It might fly away. I don't know if it will do, but you know, I'll try my best for you. So I've got a tip. We're going to work on a tip today. I've still got big long nails on. I can't believe I've still not cut them. I just feel.
Like, I'm surprised as well.
Yeah, I feel badass. Yeah, I have stabbed myself a few times. Yep. I did stab myself. So I did slightly soften the tips. Just feel so badass in long pointy nails. I mean, who would?
So just let's get this straight. You climbed a tree in those nails today.
Yes, I climbed a tree in these nails.
Oh my god.
See? I can do anything. Anything. Well, maybe not, but yeah. I can climb a tree to rescue the cat.
Why did you climb the tree?
Well, you know. I know we're telling the audience and the viewers. I was, my kitten, Kit Kat, who's nearly 5 months old, decided to climb the tree. And she didn't just climb the tree like she normally does. She always climbs up to the first sort of bit where you can sort of sit, and then she'll come back down. Oh no, she went right to the top. And it's bigger than the house. It's higher than the house. That's how big it is. And I had to climb all the way up. Well, not all the way up. She came about halfway down the top sort of bit with all the branches. And then decided to walk along one of the long branches. And then I had to call her again to get her come back, and I had to grab it and drop it. I didn't just drop it, by the way, I dropped it and Vanessa caught her. Vanessa did catch it, but yeah.
He didn't just throw her out of the tree.
She was walking along going, meow, meow. And I'm shouting, you get her shouting, and going, come on, come to me, what's wrong with you? Never mind. So I'm going to use chartreuse on my background. Nice and bright. I want to do something nice and bright today because it's bright where Adam is in Hartlepool, but where I am in Stoke-on-Trent, it's miserable. So, so miserable. So I'm going to pop that in the lamp. I'm going to put top coat on, and this is not any old top coat. This is the ultra matte top coat. So it looks shiny when you apply it. Yeah, so it looks nice and shiny when you apply it, and then you put it into the lamp and it goes all nice and matte. There we are, look, nice and matte. We're going to do a blue butterfly, and we're going to use blue blood. Not blue blood, royal blood. Same thing.
Royal blood.
Yeah. Gonna use some royal blood. Gonna use Azori. Or Azor. Does that Azor?
I think you can say it either way.
Right, so what I'm gonna do is take my darker colour, which will go to sort of towards the middle, really, of the butterfly. So I'm just gonna sort of start to map it out nice and thin, firstly, flat brush. We're gonna have two wings going up there. And there shall be some wings here. So now I'm gonna get that dark colour on a detail brush. I like to just kind of map it out first because it helps you get the symmetry.
Right, so blue blood, there's a few factors.
Go on.
It's the blood type is the Rh negative.
Okay.
Most of them have that.
Most of them, who are them?
The European monarchy.
Like right. The ages.
Okay.
Silver spoons, goblets and plates add to it. So having a high level of silver, eating with it and drinking from it, causes antibacterial properties.
Really?
Yeah, and also it's something to do with the condition of
our
literally caused blue skin and rather pronounced blue veins and arteries. The other thing is that a lot of the royals never really went out in sunlight, so they were very pale, which showed up their blue veins. The conclusion, this is three things. We can be very certain that a combination of very unique Rh factor, blood type, along with bluing effect of high use of silver with very translucent skin, created the term blue blood. There is no doubt that the common person or peasant would marvel at the skin and the pronounced blue colour of the royal blood coursing through the royal veins. Nowadays, everyone just wants a bit of a tan.
I know. Nobody wants to be pale and...
Well, that was the other thing. If you had a tan, it meant that you worked out in the fields doing manual labour. So obviously they would avoid getting a tan, wouldn't they? And that is your bit of useless information from Adam.
I think that was quite good, actually. I enjoyed that one. So I'm taking a zoo now and I've gone round the edge here. And I'm going to do the same with the edges of these wings. And then what we're going to do is we're going to bring this in. So we're just getting a little bit of the product and bring it in. And then we're going to slowly kind of smudge those together. And as we do that, we can create these wonderful little lines detail, which I love. So a bit of product, and then we start to merge them together, and then we can create those little lines of detail. So we've got those little lines of detail. We can pop that in the lamp. So you're kind of doing the detail on the nail all at the same time. You see, you're putting your colour on and then swiping through to create those little tiny little lines that make it look really interesting. What I'm going to do now is add, we want white. So I'm going to just going to slightly lighten that with the white. Just a little bit lighter. Then we're going to add a few little dots product towards the edge. And then what we're going to do is we're going to take a clean brush, come into those dots and pull through. Direction's always going to the middle, so you get some more detail. I'm going to flash cure that, and I'm going to do the same around the wings at the top, which are sort of around the edges. So again, pulling through with a clean brush. Flash cure that. Now I want a little bit of Snow White and we want some black. So we've got Serious Black. So with the white, what I'm going to do is come from that edge there and then this edge here, and the same with this, just to highlight the shape. Same there and there, and then the same at the top. It only needs to be thin, you don't need a lot. Now with the black, we're going to create the body, the head and body of the butterfly. And also the little antennae with the tiniest amount of black. You hardly need any product. Let me just pop that in. So now we're gonna go with black. So this is serious black again. And what I'm gonna do is gonna go round the edge of our gorgeous little butterfly. Giving her a lovely little frame. And we're gonna pull in a few lines for detail. And we're going to do the same round the bottom. Let me just flash cure that first though, because I know I will knock that with my fingers. I'm going to do the same here. In the lamp. So I'm just going to add a little bit of gold leaf, because everybody knows, if you watch this channel, I'm slightly obsessed with it at the minute.
Just a bit.
And my heart.
So you've got it, so it just has to be used.
It's just so pretty. I just think it's quite a good thing to use to kind of fill in spaces, but add a bit more pizzazz. Because look, that instantly adds glamour. We have glamour right there on the nail. Let me just cure that bit of matte top coat. And we are going to go over the top with matte. So let's go with the matte top coat now, because I just love it. Clearly another product that I am obsessed with.
Just slightly.
There you are. There she is. Beautiful blue butterfly. It's got a little bit of detail.
Looks like something that would be in like a
Julia Donaldson book.
Yeah.
You know, like the Gruffalo and things like that.
Yeah.
It like just flies off the page.
Yeah. I like it. Beautiful, very pretty. Mm. And it's like cool little technique of dragging through the two colours to give you sort of texture and detail. Makes it a little bit easier, I think, as well. So there you are. Hope you've enjoyed watching me create a beautiful butterfly. Don't forget to check us out on Facebook and Instagram. And if you love this video, please give us a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe. And I'll see you in the next video. Bye-bye.
And bye-bye from me.